do my best to find some kind of glow. I'm giving it some heart and soul now. From the darkest grace, the sun bursts, clouds break. Yeah, we see that fire from the streets of
Alright, so we went on an RV trip to Yosemite and Sequoia / Kings Canyon. We ended up getting the RV for free, so we totally jumped on the opportunity to take it out and take some pictures of it in nature. So here are two of my coworkers, Irene and Julia, and we were off to the RV park to pick it up in Dublin. Here we are pulling in El Monte RV, the spot. We ended up getting there pretty early, so we were there like 7:30, didn't open until 8 though, so we did a little bit of grocery shopping, and then headed back. We were still a little bit early, but the guy let us check in, signed some paperwork, got some insurance, because you guys gotta get that. Next, they showed us how everything worked, which was super cool of them, so all the hookups, all the little tabs and compartments.
Wow, first impression.
She showed us the electrical panel, which showed us how to heat up the water, turn the TVs on, and everything like that.
First impressions?
Very modern.
Very modern.
So, only RV we've been in was like an elementary school, and it did not look like this.
Granite countertops, double-decker bathroom, shower, and the master bedroom. All right, we're about to take off, but the sheer girth of this thing.
Massive.
So roomy.
Look at the screen we got. Holy. First stop on the El Monte RV trip.
Wow.
Breakfast.
So gas in this thing.
Just a lot.
On the dot.
So stop number one was Yosemite. We showed up to the park, drove down to the valley, and kind of explored there for a little bit. Took a bunch of pictures of nature, got to explore some of the trails. But overall, the thing handled pretty well going up the mountain roads. Didn't struggle too much, however, you know, it is just massive, so it just takes a lot longer to brake, a lot longer to get going. But the windy turns are definitely a little rough. We were also there on a random Thursday, so it wasn't too crowded. Got a great sense on the way back as well. So we checked into our first RV park, which was Yosemite Lakes. This is probably one of the nicer ones we've been to, actually the nicest one we went to. But the most expensive as well, but it had a lot of amenities. You can see here the front office was very, very nice. Our guy here, Tom, hooked us up really well with a lot of information. Told us all about the site, even tried upselling us a little bit here.
Now what's your guess?
But overall, yeah, definitely the nicest one we had.
We're guessing the number of gumballs in this bucket here.
More?
300?
Less?
I think 225.
That's a decent size.
Like, do I count a row? I'll go in between 275.
275.
278, because it's always
going to
be an odd.
I don't know if you can see, but this is moving out.
Slide out, baby.
It is sliding out. Right here. That's going in. That's going out. And we get more room. It's great.
Woo! Wow.
Should be enough. Gals made some great ramen.
So this is me putting together the bed. I slept above the cabin. The girls took the master bedroom, but yeah, you pull that down and you sleep.
Waking up this morning, around 6 in the morning. It is pretty chilly. The heater kind of stopped working in the middle of the night, so we were kind of freezing. Here I am, all bundled up. Head to toe, wearing leggings, base layers. But we're gonna do a sunrise hike. They got the front desk telling us about it. Up there, in like a Wi-Fi tower?
Something like that.
But yeah, it's pretty freaking cold.
Just arrived, the Wi-Fi tower. And we do got a great view.
So we didn't really know anything about RV parks coming into this. Doing a little bit of research online, found out that these are nicer. They usually have bathrooms, showers. In this case, the shower was free. And other activities to just fill your time with at the park. Kind of a great way to ease into this RV trip. As you can see here, there was this nice wooden sign that showed us where everything was. We're from San Francisco, so zooming in on that there. They had mini golf. Just open to the public. It was early and it was chilly, but they just had it out, so we put it around. Julia did great. As you can see here, a lot of great swings. Almost went in.
Oh! What?
So after that, we went ahead and made some breakfast. My famous breakfast sandwiches. They're pretty much just eggs and croissants. And then we made it down to the valley again and took some pictures of the RVs. You can tell here it's pretty tight to find parking anywhere. Cars whizzing by, we kind of take up the entire lane. But we're able to get some cool pictures, moved over to tunnel view, got some more great pictures. Coincidentally enough, we parked in the bus lane because there wasn't any RV parking. But as you can see here, a bus showed up at the same exact time, kind of at a standoff there. After that, we went down south to Wawona, I think is how you say it. But very underrated, like not many people were there. I had the whole hike to ourselves, could have done a lot more too. But a great overall southern section of Yosemite that I feel like isn't explored as much.
Just got to Sequoia RV Park and it's self-check-in here. So for this one, we're finding a spot first and then checking in. A little bit backwards, if you ask me. So what we do with our campsite when we first arrive, pretty dark out, but we level our thing so it's just flat. So we don't have to worry about sleeping on a slant or anything like that. But luckily, we have an electronic leveler, which just does automatically for us. I can hear the floor shaking, but the jacks are just being put down underneath us, and it just electronically makes sure we are level. Next thing we do that Irina's already doing is plug in our electricity, dry in the cables so they don't get electrocuted, and we have
electricity
power.
Oh, that's a good. Oh, wait, is there a switch to turn it on?
And now we have power.
Yeah.
And the third thing is we slide out the side here. And look at that, a ton more room. So we decided that we wanted a shower, so we have to hook up our water to the city water pump. That'll let us use all the water directly from the campsite into the shower. So we don't have to worry about filling up our water tank and stuff. So as you can see, fresh water tank, city water connection at the bottom. That one connects directly to everything so we can just import all this water straight from the ground. So for the shower, again, here is the driver's seat, another bed pulled down, entrance. Showering here, you saw we plugged in the water, so we turn on the tank heater up here, and then turn on the water heater here, and we have 6 gallons of hot water that it heats up. It takes about 30 minutes. Then you get in here, and we're going to get a decent sized shower. You know, it's not huge, but it does the trick. Also, this is still on here because we are at the end of day 2 and we're trained not to use the toilet because if we return it without emptying the black water, it's like a $50 fee or something like that. So we're doing our best to do it. Also, this pot is here because I thought 6 gallons wouldn't be enough and I would need to boil water to pour on myself. But thankfully, 6 gallons lasted all of us. So yeah, that's the showering situation. Pretty comfy. We'll probably shower again tomorrow here. Thank you.
So we decided to get off to a little bit of a later start this morning, take it easy, kind of relax a bit before we headed off to Kings Canyon and Sequoia.
Take us through what you got.
And it's the SS Delicacy.
Wow.
Right, so all of this is closed. So unfortunately, we can only go this route. But none of us have ever done that before, so that will be exciting.
The pictures also look really pretty.
Yes. So we are going to be doing the Kings Canyon Scenic Byway.
So, of course, we were bummed that we couldn't go to Sequoia, but Kings Canyon has a lot to offer, and to be honest, I don't know too much about it, but it was very, very underrated. But when we were there, driving through these mountains into the canyon was pretty freaking cool. Highly recommend it. I mean, there was no one there either. It was us and, what, felt like 20 other people. It was awesome.
A few questions. I'm going to ask, now it's our last day here. What's been your favorite part about the RV? Not the trip, but living in an RV for 3 days.
My favorite part about being in an RV is just being able to spend time with your friends in one small space. Really creates a great bonding environment. And it was a new experience for me, so I felt like very outdoorsy when I am not. So that was fun.
Wow. Julia?
Oh wow, that was like much more meaningful. I was just gonna say it's nice having all your stuff in one spot and not having to move any of it. And it's just really convenient.
I'm much probably saying convenience, probably in there. Just how big it is. There's a ton of room in there. Nice having your kitchen in there too. Everything you need, you can just set up camp and it feels like you have a home wherever you are. All right. What about your least favorite parts here?
My least favorite part, this is expensive. Gas expensive. Mileage expensive. RV spots are more expensive than I thought they were.
Yeah. I don't know how much money you save by not like spending night at a hotel, but you're still booking RV spots to stay in. Well, I guess we do save money because we don't have to eat out because we have a kitchen. But my least favorite part was the heating.
Hey, chilly. The heater kind of stopped working in the middle of the night, so we were kind of freezing.
And I was very cold night one and had zero sleep.
So heating and cost, one of the two biggest things. I was the driver, so for me, it was probably
the size
of it. It's so hard, the park thing.
All right, we're about to take off with the sheer girth of this thing.
It is massive.
Finding parking, getting gas.
Getting gas.
You know, it's like, I don't know, we spent like $150 on half a tank. And yeah, just finding parking and making tight turns is really tough with the thing. It's like 33 feet, I think. So definitely not the most intuitive thing to drive.
So after leaving Kings Canyon National Park, we went ahead and drove down and saw probably one of the coolest sunsets I've seen in a while. What made it really cool is all the fog, the thick, dense fog down there, made for a really awesome sunset.
Wow. Oh. Wow.
But what we didn't know is that we actually had to drive through that fog. So once we got down there, it was pretty hectic and we can probably see like 5 feet in front of us. It was really bad. We even got it this morning for a dense fog advisory. I've never seen one of these things. I don't know if it's common around Fresno. So put in the comments below if it is, if you're from the area. But we had no idea what was going on and it was pretty terrifying.
This is dangerous. I could pour a lot on.
So our other campsites have had dumps in our spots, so we thought we'd have the same dump at this spot. As you can see, our gray water tank is pretty full, so we pulled in here. It took us two tries, it's kind of a tight spot, but then we realized there's no dump. So we can't use any of this stuff going down the drain, can't use the shower, we were thinking. So instead of driving the car back out and dumping it, we decided to
wait till tomorrow because we only have a couple more hours of the day left because it's almost 9. And we have to wake up around 5 to drive back anyways. So instead of wasting the next couple hours dealing with the black water and gray water, we decided to enjoy each other's company, have a nice last meal, and have a great night.
We also thought about showering at our RV, but of course we can't because of the gray water situation. But the shower here only takes cards that were sold between 8 and 4 p.m. So we're too late to get a hot shower here as well. So fill up these jugs with warm water and dump it over ourselves. So my genius idea might have failed. One body of water was good and the other one came out brown.
Nasty!
So I don't think I'm gonna be showering with that anymore.
So because of my failed plan, I ended up boiling some water and I'm gonna use this pan to label that onto myself.
Can you taste it? It's like I smelled it.
Do you think I added more than you?
What?
It's not terrible, but it's not great.
There they are. I'm so excited. 3 days in, last night here, day 3. Would you recommend someone do an RV trip? And if you were to do this trip again, what would you change about the RV?
I would recommend an RV trip if you get a smaller RV that's more fuel efficient.
Our MPG is 9.
I would do this again in this size.
If El Monte pays for everything.
El Monte if I had to pay for this RV, no.
No, yes, I would not do it again. Unless I had, like, I guess, 8 people to split it with.
Yeah, that's true.
But there's not...
Then that's really
then
crowded.
Then it gets very crowded.
And, like, we can't sit around the table like this.
Good answers. So overall, yes, if it was free, but probably not.
Yeah.
After that, we settled in for the night and woke up a couple hours later to start our drive back to Dublin. But first, we had to dump out our gray water that we didn't do the night before, so we read the instruction manual to make sure we knew how to do it. I just filmed while I let the girls kind of figure it out. So luckily, we had gotten there early enough where there was no one else behind us. There wasn't any pressure applied to get this done fast. We'd heard stories about people kind of fumbling and not being able to get the tanks to flush, sitting there in pretty dirty water. Here's the system. You take this black tube, you twist it on, and you pull the two levers. First you pull the black water, and then you pull the gray water to help flush it out, and you just let it drain. We had used the sink in the shower pretty often. Obviously shower only once, but the sink was used every day, and 4 days for only one draining seems like a good amount of space in the tank. Would probably recommend flushing out the tank any chance you get. Here are the girls cleaning out the last of the tube, and then we were off back down the mountain.
We just arrived at our drop-off station. We dropped Irene off to get the car. But here are our overall stats here. So overall, we drove 674 miles. I probably started this on like 50 miles in, so round up to like 700 miles. Total driving time at about an hour here, so 21 hours total driving time. And our average MPG was 8.7, so pretty much a gas go for it.
The return process was really easy. All we had to do was bring it back, check for damages, and make sure the tanks were filled to, you know, how we picked them up at. Overall, customer service really, really good here. Highly recommend the staff. But when we got back, you know, we really, really missed our car.
All right, back in the normal car. It is very small.
But it's so nice.
I'm very close to the steering wheel now, and the windshield is not a movie screen anymore. But it's all right.
But it's so nice. But it's nice. It feels smooth. There's no creaking. The brakes are working, like opening and closing.
You'll hear all the rattling going on. It's pretty nice.
As you can tell from that commentary, there were pros and cons with traveling in the RV. Those cons being, you know, it's just a huge gas guzzler. It just makes a lot of noise when you're driving too. But pros, you know, it's definitely an adventure, something I never thought I would try. I would highly recommend it to someone. If you're thinking about it, try it out. You might love it. For me, it just was personally too big and would definitely get a smaller one in the future. But thanks for tuning in and enjoy.